Good evening. Thank you for coming back to another Tony Montana video. A big shout out to Bulldog and Kennels. This is a continuation of the video I made, I think it was today, or I posted today, in regards to genetic traits and if they, if I think that they're going to go basically be inherited to the next generation. As you can see, my dogs aren't killing each other. They're not looking to kill each other. They are animal aggressive. I've always told, expressed that they are animal aggressive with dogs outside the pack. Even within the pack, there are a couple of them that don't get along. And I'm always on top of them to make sure that I am always asserting my alpha role into the pack here. And here we have two females and a male. The male has a collar. The two females are next to them. They will sometimes tag team the male. Sometimes they will help the male. Here in these situations, I have to be careful how the one that just yelp, how they react. If they get angry and they want to retaliate, I will have to stop it, just so that way they don't get too rough. Now, Bulldog and Kennels was like, yeah, you know, I see that you raise them to be or have that pack mentality and seems to work, but is that something that you could continue down the line, generational? Can that be inherited into the next generation? That particular trait, past that trait of being, you know, okay with all the dogs within the pack, is that something that is passable? And I will say that this is these are dogs way before they are American Pitbull Terriers. They are canine. They are in, you know, they are in a family of animals that are naturally pack mentality, or that they have that nature of being in a pack. These animals are not solitary animals. You understand? American Pitbull Terriers have been refined to seek something different, seek something extra. They added the dominance and ultimate dominance into the equation, but I would say that this is not something new. All the dogs have it. Some dogs can be you can definitely help them learn like that, help them learn the social behaviors that you want, you know, in terms of, but it's something that they have to have within them. And because I know that these are dogs, and dogs are by nature, you know, social animals within, you know, they want to be in groups, they like to be in groups. But this American Pitbull Terrier has been enhance that they want to dominate. Make sure that in an environment with other animals, make sure that they everybody else or all the other animals know that they are the dominant animal in the area. Here is where I include myself in the pack. I add myself into it and make sure that to let them know from get-go, I dictate what goes and what doesn't go, what's okay and what's not okay. And I've learned from, obviously, from animal documentaries that this happens in the wild. It has happened that the alpha animals, male and female, will dictate, hey. See, he's trying to dominate by mounting, and that's what this one was trying to do. That is natural, normal behavior, but again, hey, no. But in another situation, that could lead to a fight. So again, I'm the one that if this continues, I will go and pinch, kind of like on the side, kind of like what in the grown, not the alpha would do. Go if this is showing some total dominance and the alpha doesn't like it, the alpha will actually go and shake him harder to put him in his place. But I'm not gonna do that. If it goes too bad, then I would give him a little spanking, but whoop, you know. But again, all in so that there is a level of peace here, but that orchestrating. But again, this is all because they are dogs. And I know people say, wow, but these American people tell you, it's impossible. Bro, people, they are lions. You know, there are bears. There are animals that are there to eat us. We are the part of their food chain, you know. And we have them. We control them. There's people that have them. And together, some of them are enemies to each other. But they're together because, again, you are triggering things in their, you know, perhaps long ago, you know, we people and animals, you know, like, you know, people that believe in the Bible would say that, you know, before the animal who attacked the people and the blah, 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 you know, no offense in the people that believe in that. But, you know, that could be the reason if you want to go that way. But if you can believe and you can see it in circuses, hey, here I have to stop it. Because if I allow it, might get into a more confrontation. This female got mad and was going at it, and he could have gotten back. So I have to control it. And sometimes when they both get at the same time, I have to control it by stopping, giving them a timeout. But it works. It works. But again, there will be a point that I really see that they've gotten to a point that they get to that the point of no return too often. I'm like, okay, you're getting to that point too often. I have to separate. You guys can't be together. But again, it's all about using the nature of the animal. I am not making something different. I'm not making a dog fly, you know, I'm not making something, it's just natural. So the trait is there already, so and it's being carried forward. It, like, if you don't do anything at all, and you just blindly breed American people terriers without looking at any other care, you're going to get this pack mentality more naturally. I would say that none of these dogs, or at least 80, let me be fair because they're puppies. Maybe they say more than 60% of these dogs, these puppies, and the dogs I've had before, more than 60% would not have been getting along with any particular dog, any dog. But because they're in my hands and I'm carefully guiding them, I'm trying to trigger those specific genetic traits that they already have of being in a family. And I always have to begin to be careful. Because these are two females. And she's a little, right now wasn't upset, but that one was getting upset. So I have to make sure that she doesn't go into that same degree. Because if that both get in the same degree of temperature, the male would automatically trigger himself into the equation. And there would have been a fight. See, these are things that are, hey, these guys always leave me. Come up, come back. So these are things that I do. But it's not because, you know, wow, I don't have, it's, you know, I keep in mind they're dogs, and I keep in mind that I have to pay attention. Always be awake. I can't just, you know, the times that I've had accidents because, you know, I'm not paying attention, had earphones on, this and that. But, you know, that it is what it is. Anyway, I'm going to leave it at this. Bulldog and Kennels, I appreciate your comment. And till next time.